सो हाई गाइज एंड वेलकम बैक वंस अगेन टू अनदर सेशन ऑफ PIB 247. मैं हूँ मनीष मिश्रा एंड इन टुडेज सेशन एज यूजुअली वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सम मोर क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द PIB न्यूज विच आर इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर द ESI सेक्शन ऑफ RBI ग्रेड बी एंड अबाउट. ऑलराइट, सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द सेशन गाइज. बट बिफोर वी बिगिन, इफ यू आर कमिंग हियर फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम, डू सब्सक्राइब टू आवर चैनल एंड प्रेस दिस बेल आइकन. यू कैन ऑल्सो जॉइन दिस टेलीग्राम ग्रुप फॉर अपडेटेड इन्फॉर्मेशन रिगार्डिंग द सेशंस एंड ऑल्सो रिगार्डिंग द कोर्सेज. So let's talk about the very first question, which says the Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship has launched the customized crash course program for COVID-19 frontline workers as the central component of one of its scheme. So you have to name that scheme under which this customized crash course program for COVID-19 health frontline workers has been launched. So remember, the Prime Minister Narendra Modi has launched this program under the central component of Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana, the 3.0. Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana ka, we all know that third edition is going on for 1 year. And under this new scheme, which is known as Customized Crash Course Program for COVID-19 Frontline Workers, has been launched. Now, what is the objective? Why this Customized Crash Course Program has been launched? So this will create skilled non-medical healthcare workers to fill the present and future needs of manpower in the health sector. So guys, as we recently saw in the COVID-19 second phase, in the second phase, what happened was there was an acute shortage of the medical workers. Bahut sari shortage ho gayi thi medical workers ke, due to which the medical care would not be provided to the patients on time. All right. So to fill that gap, this training will be provided to the non-medical healthcare workers so that in the emergency time, they can also give the medical services. All right, getting my point? So I hope the objective is clear. And what about the coverage? So this program would be conducted in 111 training centers spread across 26 states, and about 1 lakh frontline workers will be benefited with this program. Also remember, it will be, the duration of this program will be 2 to 3 months with a total outlay of rupees 276 crores. Do remember the total outlay. The total outlay is how much? 276 crores, and it will be under implementation for 2 to 3 months, which means the total duration for this crash course program will be 2 to 3 months. All right, now what will be the job roles? Kaun se job roles unko under which job roles they will be provided training? So they will be provided training for home care support, for basic care support, for advanced care support also, for emergency care support, for sample collection support, and for medical equipment support. So all these kind of support will be provided to these non-medical healthcare workers. And during the emergency time, these non-medical healthcare workers can provide medical services to the patient. All right. So this was about this news. And therefore, guys, the correct answer should be what? Option C, Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana. And I hope aap sabko pata hai that Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana was launched in the year 2015 with an objective to provide short-term vocational training to the youth. Short-term skill training provide karane ke liye 2015 mein ye scheme launch ki gayi thi by the Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, which is headed by Dr. Mahendranath Pandey. Mahendranath Pandey is the minister, and what is the Lok Sabha constituency of Mahendranath Pandey? It's Chandoli. Chandoli, which is of course in Uttar Pradesh. And do remember that this scheme is being implemented by National Skill Development Corporation, NSDC. All right. So option C is the correct answer. I hope this is clear. And now let's move ahead to question number 2. Which ministry has virtually inaugurated the second National Sickle Cell Conclave on Sickle Cell Disease? Now, what is this sickle cell disease? Let's first talk about this. So remember, I hope we all know that we have RBCs, red blood cells, in our inner blood, which is generally round in shape. Okay, RBCs are generally round in shape, and what they do, they generally provide oxygen to all the parts of the body while flowing through the blood vessels. All right, but if a person who has a sickle cell disease, his or her RBCs shape would be like a sickle. Okay, the shape of RBC will become like this. All right, and in that case, होता क्या है कि जो RBCs हैं वो जल्दी डाई हो जाती हैं, और ऑक्सीजन की जो शॉर्टेज है वो कंटिन्यूसली बनी रहती है बॉडी में. ओके, सो दिस इज नोन एज सिकल सेल डिजीज. एंड ऑन रिगार्डिंग दैट डिजीज, सेकेंड नेशनल सिकल सेल कॉन्क्लेव हैज बीन इनॉग्रेटेड बाय द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ ट्राइबल अफेयर्स. लेट मी टेल यू द आंसर फर्स्ट, देन वी विल मूव ऑन टू द न्यूज. मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ ट्राइबल अफेयर्स हैज इनॉग्रेटेड द सेकेंड नेशनल सिकल सेल कॉन्क्लेव. नाउ द क्वेश्चन इज, व्हाई मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ ट्राइबल अफेयर्स इज इनॉग्रेटिंग इट? Because this disease, sickle cell disease, is very prominent in the tribal people. जो हमारे देश के ट्राइबल लोग हैं उनके बीच में ये डिजीज़ बहुत ज़्यादा प्रोमिनेंट है, इसलिए उस पर कंट्रोल पाने के लिए मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ ट्राइबल अफेयर्स इसके टूवर्ड्स जो है वो कदम उठा रही है। ऑलराइट, सो द मिनिस्टर ऑफ ट्राइबल अफेयर्स विच इज हु इज मिस्टर अर्जुन सिंह मुंडा, अर्जुन मुंडा इज द मिनिस्टर ऑफ ट्राइबल अफेयर्स इज लोकसभा कंस्टिट्यूएंसी इज खुंटी इन झारखंड। ओके, ही हैज वर्चुअली इनॉग्रेटेड द सेकेंड नेशनल सिकल सेल कॉन्क्लेव ऑन सिकल सेल डिजीज एंड इट एम्स टू डिस्कस वेज एंड मीन्स टू इन्हांस अवेयरनेस प्रिवेंशन एंड मैनेजमेंट इनिशिएटिव। बेसिकली इस डिजीज को हम कैसे प्रिवेंट कर सकते हैं, इसके रिगार्डिंग हम कैसे अवेयरनेस स्प्रेड कर सकते हैं, हाउ वी कैन स्प्रेड अवेयरनेस रिगार्डिंग दिस डिजीज, हाउ वी कैन प्रिवेंट दिस डिजीज, वॉट आर द मैनेजमेंट इनिशिएटिव दैट कैन बी कैरिड आउट टू टैकल दिस डिजीज, ऑल दीज थिंग्स विल बी डिस्कस ड्यूरिंग दिस नेशनल सिकल सेल कॉन्क्लेव। राइट, एंड रिमेंबर दीज आर द एरियाज विच आर सफर्ड फ्रॉम द डिजीज इन इंडिया, लाइक वी हैव झारखंड, महाराष्ट्र, मध्य प्रदेश, छत्तीसगढ़, वेस्टर्न ओडिशा, ईस्टर्न गुजरात एंड इन द पॉकेट्स ऑफ नीलगिरी हिल्स इन नॉर्थ तमिलनाडु एंड केरला। सो बेसिकली अ लॉट ऑफ पार्ट ऑफ इंडिया इज सफर्ड फ्रॉम द डिजीज। ओके, बहुत सारा जो पार्ट है वो इंडिया में इस डिजीज से सफर करता है। ऑल्सो रिमेंबर अ मोबाइल वैन वॉज ऑल्सो फ्लैग्ड अप बाय द मिनिस्टर ऑफ ट्राइबल अफेयर्स फॉर स्क्रीनिंग ऑफ सिकल सेल डिजीज एंड द इवेंट गाइज विल फीचर डिस्कशंस अबाउट द लेटेस्ट एडवांसेज ऑल्सो एंड वॉट विल बी द फ्यूचर ट्रेंड्स इन द ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ सिकल सेल डिजीज ऑन वल्नरेबल पेशेंट पॉपुलेशन विद अ स्पेशल फोकस ऑन वुमेन एंड चिल्ड्रन। इस डिस्कशन में जो स्पेशल फोकस होगा वो किसके ऊपर होगा, महिलाओं पे और बच्चों पे। ओके, सो दिस वॉज अबाउट दिस न्यूज एंड देयरफॉर द करेक्ट आंसर इज व्हाट, मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ ट्राइबल अफेयर्स। एंड नाउ लेट्स मूव अहेड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 3। मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ साइंस हैज इशूड अ स्पेशल कॉल एज अ पार्ट ऑफ इट्स मिशन प्रोग्राम बायोटेक किसान फॉर विच एरिया, स्टेट और रीजन। सो मिशन प्रोग्राम बायोटेक किसान के अंतर्गत अंडर दिस बायोटेक किसान दे हैव इशूड अ स्पेशल कॉल and the question is for which area, state or region this special call has been issued. So let's talk about this. The department of biotechnology which is under the ministry of science, ministry of science is headed by Dr. Harshvardhan, his Lok Sabha constituency is Chandni Chowk. So the department of biotech has issued a special call for northeastern region. Okay, northeastern region as part of biotech kisan program, and remember kisan has a full form also here which is Krishi Innovation Science Application Network. Also remember biotech kisan, Biotech Kisan scheme was launched in the year 2017. It is basically a scientist and farmer partnership, scientist and farmer partnership program. And under this, what they will do, they will provide, they are providing innovative solutions in the agriculture. Agriculture ke area mein innovation provide karane ke liye, this scheme was launched in the year 2017. Alright. And now this call has been issued for the northeastern region with an aim to understand the local problems of this region. Farmers and provide the scientific solutions to these problems. All right. Now talking about the progress that has been made under this scheme till now. So far 146 biotech kisan hubs have been established covering all the 15 agroclimatic zones across 110 aspirational districts, and the scheme has benefited over 2 lakh farmers till now, and over 200 entrepreneurs have been developed in the rural areas. Okay, so these are the progress that have been made under this scheme. Now, what is the need of the present call for the northeastern region? This is because of obvious reason, because the northeast region is predominantly agrarian with 70% of its workforce engaged in agriculture and the allied activities. But despite ki there are 70% of its workforce which are engaged in agriculture and allied sector, yet the region produces merely 1.5% of country's food grains, and even they are a net importer of food grains for their domestic consumption also. अपनी domestic consumption के लिए भी उनको जो food है वो import करना पड़ता है, alright? And the northeastern region, guys, has, we all know, has untapped potential to enhance the income of the farming population by promotion of local specific crops, horticulture and plantation crops. So all these things, because of all these things, this call has been issued by the Department of Biotechnology under the Biotech Kisan scheme. So therefore the correct answer should be what, option E, northeast region. Northeast region should be the correct answer, guys. And now let's move ahead to question number 4, which is the last question. Question number 4. In order to boost the tourism sector in the aftermath of coronavirus pandemic, because guys, we all know that tourism sector, the hospitality sector has hit a lot due to this coronavirus pandemic. The Ministry of Tourism. Now who is the Minister of Tourism? Can you tell me, write down in the comment. The name of the Minister of Tourism. So this ministry has formulated 3 draft strategies with roadmaps for some areas of tourism industry. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग आर दोज एरिया। सो तीन एरियाज के लिए ड्राफ्ट स्ट्रैटेजी निकाली है और ताकि जो टूरिज्म है उसको बूस्ट किया जा सके। नाउ रिमेंबर द स्ट्रैटेजीज इज नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर द एग्जाम, वी डोंट हैव टू गो इन दैट मच डिटेल अबाउट व्हाट आर द स्ट्रैटेजीज टू बूस्ट दिस टूरिज्म इन दीज थ्री एरियाज। सो दीज आर द थ्री एरियाज, ओके, एंड रिमेंबर दीज थ्री एरियाज आर मेडिकल एंड वेलनेस टूरिज्म, रूरल टूरिज्म एंड माइस इंडस्ट्री। नाउ व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ माइस? इट इज नॉट चूहा, राइट? माइस स्टैंड्स फॉर मीटिंग्स, इंसेंटिव, conferences and exhibitions. All right, remember, meetings, incentive, conferences and exhibitions. So these are, this is the full form of MICE. This is not about the actual MICE, right? And this is basically known as business tourism. All right, business tourism, in other words, okay. So to promote tourism in these three areas of medical and wellness tourism, rural tourism and MICE tourism, the Ministry of Tourism has drafted the strategies with some roadmaps. And remember, as I told you, we don't have to go in the detail about the roadmaps, about the strategies, okay? So let's talk about this. So as we have discussed that medical and for medical and wellness tourism, for rural tourism and for MICE industry, they have came up with a strategy in order to boost the tourism sector in the aftermath of coronavirus pandemic. And what is the meaning of medical tourism here? So remember, it is a term used for traveling across international borders to obtain health care. जब हम एक देश से दूसरे देश में जाते हैं हेल्थ केयर ऑब्टेन करने के लिए, सो दिस इज नोन एज मेडिकल टूरिज्म एंड इट इज ब्रॉडली क्लासिफाइड इनटू थ्री कैटेगरीज। नंबर वन इज मेडिकल ट्रीटमेंट, देन वी हैव वेलनेस एंड रेजुविनेशन, एंड देन वी हैव अल्टरनेटिव क्योर्स। ऑलराइट, तो तीन कैटेगरीज में होती है डिवाइडेड मेडिकल एंड वेलनेस टूरिज्म। नाउ टॉकिंग अबाउट द रूरल टूरिज्म, व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ रूरल टूरिज्म हियर? सो एनी फॉर्म ऑफ टूरिज्म दैट शोकेसेस द रूरल लाइफ, आर्ट एंड कल्चर, हेरिटेज ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर रूरल एरियाज एंड देयर बाय बेनिफिटिंग द लोकल पीपल in generating their income, okay? So this is known as rural tourism. And talking about the MICE, so meeting, incentive, conferences and exhibition is the full form. This, the purpose of this is to create a networking platform for business, industries, government organizations, non-government organizations and private offices, and engage in for engagement in the meaningful conversations. It is also known as meeting industries or event industry, and as I told you, the business tourism, all right? And what is the significance why they are doing this? So it will definitely helping accelerating the country's development, because someone is coming to India for the tourism, it will definitely contribute towards India's economy and development, and it will definitely attain the objective of Atmanirbhar Bharat. It will also give a boost to the economy, as we have discussed, in the form of income generation, and it will also create employment. Strategy for rural tourism will develop and promote the local products, okay, and it will also again promote the Atmanirbhar Bharat, preservation of natural heritage and environment, and renewal of cultural pride. And not only it will provide the high quality jobs, it will also enhance the investment in India. Of course, if any kind of business conclave is organizing in India, then definitely some kind of investment will come, okay. So this was about this news, and I have told you the answer already. 1, 2 and 3 should be the correct answer. Option C for medical and wellness tourism, for rural tourism and for MICE industry. All right. So that's it for the session, guys. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care and God bless.